Okay. And similarly, I can write 16. After 16, we will have to write 22. And 22 is 2 by 14 plus 24 and 2 by 14 plus 25 into 5 by 14. When you add up all these, you will get this one equal to 294 by 14, and this is equal to 21. So the average age comes out to be 21. Now this tells you the difference between the median and the average. Average, you see here, is this one, while the median is this one. So these are actually statistical terms with the help of which you can analyze a given data. So median and average are two different terms. Okay. Now this average in quantum mechanics we call, this average we call the expectation value. This average we call the expectation value. So for all the quantum mechanical parameters, we will find the expectation value. Then the fifth question in this one is, what is the average of the square of ages? What is the average of the square of ages? Average of the square of ages. And why this one is necessary, you will come to know in a while, that this one is also really necessary. Like, we will say that square of the ages will be what? Like, it is square of the age means j square. And average means this one, and this will be equal to j summation on j and j squared p of j. Right? This will be, is j was here, so it was jpj. If j square is there, so it will be j square times p of j. So I can write this thing, the square of the ages will be equal like this. And now the another sixth parameter that I want to know, what is the variance? What is the variance of the distribution? What is the variance of distribution? So the variance of distribution is first, let me explain a little bit what is meant by variance, why we need this term as well. Variance is actually called the spread from the average value. And let me explain this by an example. Again, we take an example of, let's say, the students again, but a different example in order to show you this thing as well. If this is the number of years and these are the number of students of the same age, then we are having, let's say, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10, for example. And we are having the same situation again here as well, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. And this is N of J, and this one is J, which is in this direction. Okay, let's say I'm having a distribution, and the distribution is like this, that one student is of age 4 and one student is of age 6. And there are 8 students of age 5. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. And I'm having one student of, let's say, here to here, 9. Okay. Means I am having one student of each of this age, but there is one student, one age which is 5, and there are actually 2 students of it. Here, this one and this one, these are 2 distributions, but now look at the different parameters. That what about the median age here and here? The median age. 5. You know from here that the median age will be the age which will have the same number of students younger and older. Look here to 5. The same number is younger and the same number is older. So here the median age comes out to be 5. And what about the median age here? Look here. From 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This will be also the same. So 1, oh sorry, here this one is not, because this one is 0. So look here, 1, 2, 3, 4, this side, 1, 2, 3, 4 on this side. So it means the median age here is 5 as well. Because 5 is the age from which we are having 4 younger and 4 older. So it means the median age in that one and this one is the same, while the distributions are completely different. So it means this median age is not covering up the statistical data. It means it cannot differentiate between the two statistical information. What about the average age? And this one, what is the average age? How you calculated the average age? Here is the average age. So you will multiply J, P, J. Can you calculate the average age here?
Yes.
Okay, look here. That you will say J, J is 4, 4. And then PJ is 1 over 10, because 4 age is 1, and then the total number is actually 10. So you are having 1 over 10, plus this is 5, and this one they are 8, so 8 over 10, plus The age is 6 and you are having 1 over 10. 8 of them, you will get 4 over 10 plus 40 over 10 plus 6 over 10. And this will give you how much? 50 over 10. Because 4, 6, 10 and 40, 50. And this will give you 5. So the average age comes out to be 5 here. And now come here, calculate the average age here. Age 1 is this and 1 over 10. Plus 2 and 1 over 10. Plus 3 and 1 over 10. Plus, okay, I will have to write here, plus 4, 1 over 10. Plus 5 and 2 over 10. Plus, and so on, you do calculate, you will get again 5. So the average age also comes out to be 5. Then the two informations are the same while the distributions are different. But look here. If I want to plot this one like this, or let me plot it with a different color. Like, I do plot it like this. What about this one? This will be plotted like this. Right? So, which one is having the more spread?
Second.
This is having more spread, while this one is having less spread around the average value. This is the average value. This is the average value and the spread is more. So the variance actually calculates the spread around the average value, and we call this thing, this variance, we call the standard deviation. So when we find for a quantum mechanical property the standard deviation, then it means that how much spread is there from the average value. The value we have measured, how much spread is there on one side and on the other side. And this J, the average value, if the average value is J, and this standard deviation I represent by sigma. Sigma is the standard deviation. Then this will be equal sigma squared. Sigma squared will be equal to J squared average minus J average squared. There is difference. Means you take the average of J squared and you subtract the average J squared from it. So I can write that the standard deviation sigma will be equal to J squared average minus J squared. And this will give you the spread around the spread around the average value. And now we come to our quantum mechanical terms, which we call the continuous variables. The continuous variables. Because in quantum mechanics, we will not deal with discrete distributions like this. Our distributions will be just like this, like the plot. They are continuous. So for the continuous distribution, I will say that from minus infinity to plus infinity, psi mod square is the probability density. If I multiply with dx and do integrate, then this will be equal to 1. This is called the normalization condition. This is called means by making the thing determined. Like from minus infinity to plus infinity, it will be somewhere. And if I calculate the expectation value or the average value, in quantum mechanics we then call the expectation value. X is now our space variable, the distance, the displacement, x. Then I will write this minus infinity to plus infinity, and this will be equal to sine conjugate x sine dx. And this will have some value. Similarly, I can write the momentum variable or the physical quantity. And later on you will come to know that in quantum mechanics the physical quantity will change to operators. The physical quantities in quantum mechanics are operators then. They are not only physical quantities. I will explain this difference when we will reach there. And this will be from minus infinity to plus infinity, sine conjugate in P, and there is a head on it, and sine in dx. And sigma will be equal to x squared average minus x average square root. So this will be actually sigma x. Similarly, sigma p will be the variance in momentum, will be p square average minus p average square and square root. Right?